there's this popular program called Stranger Things on TV. And as a fan and as a physicist, I've come up with a theory. And just for warning, there's going to be some spoilers. In Stranger Things, one of the characters, Will, gets trapped in this sort of parallel universe called the Upside Down. And when he's trapped there, his mum is, you know, really worried about him, but she figures out that he's not missing and that actually she can communicate with him when he's in this parallel universe. And she does it by stringing up some Christmas lights on the wall, and under each light bulb, she writes a letter. And so from this parallel universe, the kid manages to light up a light bulb above a letter and spell out a message to his mum.
Like a high-tech Ouija board.
Yeah, basically. And so I was thinking, as a physicist, how is this even possible? How does one communicate from a whole other universe to our universe in 1983? And so I've come up with this theory, this physics fan theory, and I think that this is possible if this parallel universe called the Upside Down is quantumly entangled with our universe. I guess we gotta understand quantum entanglement first. First of all, you've gotta get rid of everything that you know about the classical world. So in the classical world, this is a red ball and it will always be a red ball. Similarly, this is a blue ball and this will always be a blue ball. And if I sort of shuffle them around and hold one in either hand, when I say to you, you know, which one is the red ball and which one is the blue ball, we know that one of them is definitely red and one of them is definitely blue. And so it's only when I open my hand and say, okay, that was the blue ball and that was the red ball, that we knew all along that this was blue and this was red. But one of them is always blue and one of them is always red. If this was the quantum world and you couldn't tell which one was red or which was blue, they would both be red and blue at the same time. So this is like the Schrodinger's cat example. The cat is both dead and alive at the same time.
They're both purple.
Both purple. Yes, they are. So there's some sort of weird linear superposition of red and blue in the quantum world. And it's only when we, again, we open the hand and we see that this one is blue that we know this one is red. But before that, they were both. So if we have two quantumly entangled particles instead in this weird quantum mechanical world, these can have sort of any property. So what I was doing there was this color was an analogy for spin, basically, or some property of the particle. So spin up and spin down, and that is a very fundamental property of particles. And so if we have these quantumly entangled particles, they don't have any spin yet, or at least they do have spin, it's just that you can't describe one without describing the other, okay? So they're in this weird superposition state where they can be both spin up and spin down. But the thing about quantumly entangled particles is that as soon as you measure them and one becomes spin up, the other one immediately becomes spin down. So whatever one of them does, the other one has to do the exact opposite. And that's what quantum entanglement is. Poor Will, trapped in this parallel universe, if this entire universe was quantumly entangled with our universe, then anything that Will does in the parallel universe has to be reflected in our universe as well. The particles have to do the exact opposite. So say Will could take the light bulb in the parallel universe of the Upside Down and maybe put a battery to it and force the electrons in that light bulb to move around a circuit, he would have given them momentum in a direction, and therefore the particles in our universe would have to do the exact opposite. So that means they would also have to have momentum, but in the opposite direction, and therefore also move around a circuit and therefore light up a light bulb. So if he lit up a light bulb in his universe, the light bulb would also light up in our universe.
But wouldn't also Will himself have to be in both universes? And wouldn't when he moves the battery, wouldn't the whole battery have to float in the other universe?
But yeah, no, this is where this sort of theory is a little bit like, we're going to have to think about this. I mean, I'm also assuming that, you know, these light bulbs are in parallel. You know, they're not in series in their circuit. They're in parallel. I mean, this is 1983. They could be in series. I don't know. This is the kind of thing that you have to assume all the way that you go through this theory.
But you're saying if the Upside Down is a parallel universe, mm-hmm. he can manipulate the electrons in his, he'll be able to manipulate electrons in the other.
Exactly. Through quantum entanglement. That's my theory. Would you like to hear how this theory is absolutely rubbish? So there are many problems, but so as a scientist, I had to think through these problems and go through them. The first question I had was, is it even possible to make a quantumly entangled universe? Because that just seems ridiculous in my head. Turns out, not so ridiculous. So I actually found a paper, Quantum Entanglement in the Multiverse. And this is, you know, a theoretical paper, but they're actually talking about it as if we could measure whether this has actually happened in our own universe. So what they're saying is, if our universe is one of many, and the multiverse theory holds that there are many, many universes, then after the Big Bang, 10 to the minus 36 seconds after the Big Bang, to be precise, there was this period of time called inflation, where the universe rapidly inflated in the space of sort of from 10 to the minus 36 to sort of like 10 to the minus 33 seconds. So a very, very short space of time inflated very rapidly. And that has like loads of consequences on sort of how the universe is today, because any sort of teeny tiny fluctuations in the particles that were created just after the Big Bang were sort of locked in. So density fluctuations, anything like that, were then spread out over these huge distances. And that meant that then some areas of the universe are more dense than the others, and that's how you ended up getting galaxies forming there, et cetera, et cetera. So they're saying, if you have inflation in the multiverse and you're creating sort of child universes from, say, our parent universe, so lots of multiverses are sort of springing off, and you have inflation, then the same properties are going to be imprinted in one universe as in the child universe as well, like an identical twin. So that's what inflation would do. It would imprint both those things. And if you had two particles that were in this quantumly entanglement state in the beginning, then they would be quantumly entangled in these two separate universes. And the really cool thing about this paper is that they suggest that actually, if this was true in our universe, you'd actually be able to test whether that was true, because these kind of quantum entanglement fluctuations that would be imprinted in inflation, you'd still be able to see in what's called the cosmic microwave background, which is this microwave signal, which is a remnant of the Big Bang in the very early stages of the universe, where light could first escape from the early stages of the universe. So I think that's really exciting. And the fact that my crazy fan theory could actually, you know, in our own universe could exist, I was like, that was one point to me, I thought. That's one point. There is another problem, and it's something called quantum decoherence. If you have two quantumly entangled particles and you want to send a message between the two of them, say you're doing it for like encryption or something, and you move one particle, say, you know, 300 miles away, and you measure one thing to have a certain spin and momentum, and therefore the other one has to do the exact opposite. This is what Einstein was really concerned about. You were therefore sending a message faster than the speed of light, because as soon as this one is measured, this one automatically changes. And so that is sort of this spooky action at a distance, and we know that things can't travel faster than the speed of light. People have got around that now by saying, well, I had to physically move this 300 miles away first to send that message, and I couldn't have made that travel faster than the speed of light. Therefore, the message itself didn't travel faster than the speed of light. Of course, if I move that, you know, very, very close to the speed of light, say 99% of the speed of light over here, and then I transfer that message, transfer a message back, then that has traveled faster than the speed of light. But that's not possible. So as soon as I measure this one as spin up and this one as spin down, that is an irreversible process. And the reason for that is you've had to put energy into this system, okay? So you've had to say, okay, this one has to be spin up, this one has to be spin down. And what you've done is you've put energy into the universe. This has somehow interacted with the environment that it's in and with the universe. And you've increased the entropy of the universe. So for those of you who are paying attention in school, that should raise a little red flag. The second law of thermodynamics says that you cannot decrease the entropy of the universe. So we've increased the entropy by doing that measurement and measuring to say that, yes, this one is spin up and this one is spin down. And so you cannot reverse that process, because reversing it, you would have to decrease the entropy of the universe to do that. So any interaction with your environment breaks quantum entanglement. So what does that mean in terms of my crazy fan theory? As soon as Will has moved the electrons and set up the circuit in one light bulb, he couldn't do it again in that same light bulb. So when his mum has strung up the lights with a single letter under every single light, he wouldn't be able to use the same letter twice. So he would have to get very creative with his lettering. And in the show, he writes the words right here. So he uses E twice. And therefore, I don't think my theory holds, because he wouldn't be able to use E twice under our understanding of quantum entanglement and quantum decoherence.
He also uses R and H twice, doesn't he?
Right here. Yeah, okay. Okay, I'll do that one again. I can't count.
That's all right, that's quite
I was like, here is fine. Yeah.
that's quite funny though.
so I could influence his thoughts, for example. How would I influence his thoughts? Well, I'd have to change the biochemistry. And what's the biochemistry about? It's about electrons. So somehow my electrons would have to couple. They'd have to become strongly quantum mechanically entangled with Brady's electrons.